What's up? I'm Britt Burton and you're watching Beta Records TV, and today we're here with Jed Lieber, who owns the Nightbird Studios at the bottom of the Sunset Marquee. So thank you so much for stopping by today.
Oh, a pleasure.
How did you think to put the studio in the bottom of the Sunset Marquee?
It's a funny story. I was working with this wonderful guitarist, Jeff Beck, who you may know. And we were working in a room on a project of his, and somebody complained at, was it 2 or 3 in the morning or something like that? And the general manager, Rod Gruendijk, came by and he said, gentlemen, would you mind working, you know, downstairs, because we're getting some complaints, so we don't want to disturb you. But next thing you know, we're in the laundry room. So we started working down there, and it was a great place to work.
So when did it turn into a much grander scale? When did you start renovating and making it what it is today?
One of the reasons for doing it is that after my first film, I realized the recording studio that I had booked made more money than I did as the composer. And I had been working 20 hours a day for 3 months. I said, something's not right with this. So I thought, okay, build a great room and I can do better financially, have a room that I love to work in, and the hotel will be comfortable, you know, having this wonderful studio. Well, I approached them and there are all these parking spaces which were basically, you know, not being used. And I said, listen, if you give me these parking spaces, I'll build a proper room, and you'll have this amenity for your guests, and I'll be able to do my work, you know. And I was thinking, this is wonderful, you know, 24-hour room service, swimming pool. But I thought, this is great,
yeah.
You know. And the general manager liked the idea, so he gave me a certain number of parking spaces, and I built this room.
You've had tons of artists, right, come through here. I mean, almost an endless number of names.
Yeah.
Are there any artists that were either your favorites or some that you were like, whoa, I can't believe they came here?
Everybody is starstruck by someone.
Right.
You know? I think it was Monty Python that got me.
Really? And have you ever had artists who rented out for long periods of time, or is it more they come in to do the final product of one of their songs?
Both.
Both?
Writers come down here for a day or two, because they have a song idea and they want to get it down. Seal was down here for just a couple of days. Recently, Carrie Underwood was working. Yeah, Lil Wayne. If you look at it as a business, the studio rates are at the same rate or lower than they were.
Right.
20 years ago. Tell me something else that hasn't gone up in price in the last 20 years. You're too young to know video killed the radio star. Well, technology killed the songwriter, the recording studio, the engineer, the manager. I mean, I can keep going.
No, I was thinking that in my head. From a bedroom, you know, on a computer, how do you compete with that then?
There is going to be a major difference in quality. Part of the problem is that some people don't care. Part of the problem is that a lot of people can't hear the difference. And once we went to the MP3 format and everything got it squished down to an MP3, when I have gone through the trouble to have these poor interns weaving copper wire outside, right? So I can squeeze another, I don't know how many, you know, dBs of signal to noise to improve the quality, right? You have issues. At the end of the day, when I played Seal, his album in 5.1 at full bandwidth, you should have seen the look on his face. I wouldn't have traded that for anything.